fakes.
Annoying.
Huh. Alright, guys. Back from after the first episode. I'm going to try. No, I can't right away. I was gonna try to play as the girl, see.
Weird. No missions. I can do whatever?
It's like Home Alone, man. It's like, I wished my family would disappear. Let's see what her story is all about. Need to open up a beer. No, I'm just by the tree that you can obviously see. Alright.
Guess it's time to face the cupcakes. Worried that I chickened out?
No! I know you're not afraid of anything.
I mean, what's to fear? This is a great honor.
Right! Wait, I can't tell if you're being serious.
Well, there is one part that I'm really afraid of.
What's that?
I'm afraid that you won't get any food because I'm gonna beat you to the maiden's feast.
Dream on!
She's in a skirt. You're in pants.
Come on, Pokey!
Hello?
Surprise!
Whoa.
Yay!
There is my Valoria. Oh, look at my pretty girl. I can't believe. I just can't believe.
We're very proud of you. I think that's what your mother is trying to say.
Oh, she's not even dressed yet?
Can we do that after cake? Come on, cake first!
All right, but come on. Let's get this good time over with!
This sounds and feels exactly like a Disney movie, for starters.
Now, where did I put that knife?
Who needs a knife when you have hands?
Nobody touches that cake until I...
Hands are like nature's forks. All right, let's talk to this little girl.
Know where Mom's knife is, Rocky?
If I did, we'd all be eating cake right now!
Probably under there. Some inconspicuous pies in the background, but everyone's focused on the cake.
Don't suppose you have another knife in the back we can use?
I do, but your mom brought out a special one she wants to use. She wants everything to be perfect on your special day.
I'm guessing the knife talks, just like the spoon talks for that kid. I just talked to this old hermit fortune teller guy.
Grandpa Beastender? Do you know where Mom's knife is?
Wouldn't tell you if I did. I'm not doing one thing to help with this shame feast.
Shame feast?
Why do you hate the Maiden's Feast, Grandpa?
Because this used to be a town of warriors. It's a travesty, Vella.
Yeah, I'm not sure how I feel about this Maiden's Feast either, to tell you the truth.
Then fight it, girl! Stand up for yourself!
I hope you're not filling that girl's head with nonsense, Brahma.
Why'd we stop being warriors?
Lavina Clench and her ilk said there was too much bloodshed, pushed for a peace. So we went soft. Became a town of bakers.
You go from warrior clans to a baker's clan.
Hey, Gramps, want a cupcake?
Who the fuck
doesn't?
I better
go find that knife.
Don't you dare. I hid it for a reason.
You did what?
Oh, nothing.
Don't mind me. I'm just an old man. Alright.
Not until I find that knife, young lady.
She already caught me using my fingers.
Yeah.
Eyes in the back of her head, that woman.
That's what I said. Hands are nature's forks. By the way, these are pies, not knives. Sorry. They're pies, not cakes. So... I know it's under there,
Mom?
But you know, I like to explore. It's a point and click.
What if we fought the monster instead of feeding it?
That's my girl. Now that's Beastender blood talking.
Please, my loves, don't make this any harder than it already is.
It's a great honor to kill yourself.
Lavina?
What is it, girl?
Any idea where Mom's knife is?
We're late. If I knew, I would have cut that cake, shoved it down your gullets, and had us out the door already! Oh!
Can I ask you about the Maiden's Feast?
Weren't you paying attention in Maiden training?
How many of these feasts have you organized?
About a billion.
A new Grand Mag appears every 14 years, and I'd have seen 6 of them, so... Hey! Are you trying to get my age out of me? I'll never tell.
I'm pretty sure your age shows.
What is Mog Chothra?
The latest in a long, distinguished line of Grand Mogs to visit our land.
Distinguished?
Well, anything that lives that long becomes distinguished. I mean, look at me!
Ugh. Gross.
Where do creatures like Mog Chothra come from?
They come from beyond the Plague Dam.
I want to go beyond the Plague Dam someday.
It's forbidden!
Yes, it's totally a Disney movie.
You'll be lucky enough to be taken there soon in Mog Chothra's stomach.
How much do we know about these Grand Mogs?
The Grand Mogs have visited our lands for as long as anyone can remember. They hide in the wilderness.
I'm sure you
remember.
You're pretty old.
And then they come to feed. After feeding, they return to their land and, it is imagined, breed.
You actually imagine that?
Yeah, when you're this old, you kind of don't get off on normal porn, you know?
Why was I chosen?
In every town visited by a Grand Mog, the villagers vote for the maidens who represent their town's best qualities. So, in other words, beats me.
So, our town's best quality is beating old women.
Mog Chothra attacks other towns?
Of course. Mariloft just had their maiden's feast yesterday. That's how we know he's coming here next. They're a pretty tough act to follow. Amazing featherwork.
Okay. I think I know all I need to know about the Maiden's Feast.
All you need to know is how to look pretty in your dress. We'll take care of the rest.
Yeah, let's just
fight
him.
So, why don't we just fight Mog Chothra?
Silence! Talk like that could ruin the Maiden's Feast! If you destroy the feast, Mog Chothra will destroy this village, including your family! Is that what you want?
No. My grandpa doesn't look too happy about this feast.
Your grandpa is just stuck in the ways of old. Your grandma was the same way. Bless her soul. Not all of the town elders have stayed as hip and with it as I have.
I'd better go look for that knife.
And hurry. If we're late, you won't be selected and your family will be shamed.
Yeah, I want to get selected so I kill myself. Alright, let's... Nope. Alright, let's check under here.
Maybe the knife is under this towel.
No, there's the cupcakes.
Never gonna find it.
Dad, I hope you're not hiding that knife for your own good.
The only thing I'm hiding is the love of this family.
One of my mom's special dish towels, and it's still dry.
Okay.
Don't touch the red ones. Mom made those just for me.
You're going to eat all of those?
I've already had 6!
That explains a lot.
I already have diabetes. This game literally is just encouraging diabetes. Alright, so I got a cupcake, which I can give to the old guy, because he wants one, and then he'll tell me where the knife is.
For me?
I'm gonna go ahead and be an asshole.
No, Mom says you can't have any. I'm just showing it to you.
Ah, I didn't want it anyway.
Grandpa Beastender?
Huh?
I'd better go find that knife.
Maybe I'll just give it to him anyway.
For me?
For you, Grandpa.
Don't mind if I do.
Oh shit, you just ate like the wrapper and everything, man. It's like two bites and done.
Grandpa Beastender? I'd better go find that knife.
Alright, so do I have to get another cupcake now? Split it with him?
Why not?
For me?
Split it with you?
Deal!
There we go.
On second thought, you can have the whole thing.
Suit yourself. Now, where did I put that thing?
What thing?
Nothing. I didn't say anything.
I was hoping it was the talking knife, like the talking spoon. Alright, let's get on with this.
Alright, time to serve this girl up. But first, can I ask just one more time?
Honey,
why don't we just kill Mog Chothra?
Here!
Oh, honey.
Oh, we're going to miss your sense of humor.
Majestic to behold. Awe-inspiring. Powerful. Mysterious. But Mog Chothra is more than that. Merciful and generous, Mog Chothra keeps our town safe. All he asks is may he pick some of our beautiful flowers as
up
he passes
grabs,
through.
Drink me, hot stuff.
Please come, Mog Chothra, and make your selections. Welcome to the Maiden's Feast. It's
delicious. That'd be...
Show him what you're made of, Bella.
I know he'll pick you.
This can't be right.
Yeah. Purposely would want to...
For one thing, I should be in the center.
Hey, does that costume have any thorns we can use as weapons?
It does, but they're made out of chocolate. Regardless, I accept my noble burden, not with apprehension, but with joy. I give my life so that no harm comes to our village. No!
What a bitch.
I give my life! No, me!
Sheesh.
Ha! I make myself the center of any fun.
Fun size? you're making me hungry.
Hey, what do you say we break out of here?
Trying to get us all to quit so you'll win the feast, huh? Well, it's not gonna work on me. I'm in it to win it, baby.
You're making me hungry.
I'm trying to make Mog Chothra hungry. These girls have it all backwards. Think it's attractive to starve themselves.
Yes.
Want to trade something for a bite of that drumstick?
What do you got?
What are you buying? Need a towel?
How about the satisfaction of helping out a fellow maiden?
Sounds good, but
really?
Not half as satisfying as this drumstick.
I was like, really? She's fat. She's not gonna be satisfied with that.
Need a towel?
Nope. They taught us to eat daintily in finishing school. I'm warning you, buzzard! I will fuck you alive if you come near my food again!
Oh shit.
Never mind.
It's that voice actor from, Codename Kids Next Door. Yeah, Codename Kids Next Door and, Magma from X-Men Legends. Forget her name.
Want to trade something for a bite of that drumstick?
All I have is a towel. So I probably have to get something from another girl.
Never mind.
Alright, good luck, bud.
Just
get out of here. Stuff
luck.
Your face.
Bye.
Let's see what you got.
Mog Chothra with my slender frame and be remembered forever. ever as a hero.
Well, good luck.
He's only interested in the maiden that does ask to mouth. Duh.
When the monster gets close, you can use your candles to burn its eyes.
Don't distract me. I think I've got a chance to win this.
Alright, well, doom and gloom.
I hear him! Look, there he is!
I probably should have grabbed the bird. Once again, I hope this doesn't turn into a hentai.
Here I am, merciful King Mog Chakra, over here!
No! This way, Great One! I am the one you've come so far to find!
Over here! I am in bloom for you!
See? He's drawn to the flame, like a giant moth!
What? No way! He's coming my direction! Please! Don't be hasty in your decision, my lord.
Oh, yes. Take your time. Look over all your options. And then, after some careful consideration...
Tentacle rape!
Come here, little birdie. I have a treat for you.
He's coming for more. Listen, Mog Chuck.
Want to trade something for a bite of that drumstick? How about something bubbly to wash it down?
Actually, I could use a swig of something.
Okay, I'll see what I can get you.
I just want you to know.
Nothing left but crumbs. Horrible. Hey, can I have a drink of that water?
Trade you for that sweet corset you've got on. Never can be too thin.
This horrible thing? You got a deal.
Do it.
Ooh, what a relief. I feel so much.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, come on.
But this thing's just too big for me. Trade back. Oh, that poor girl.
Oh, you're dead.
Oh, no! That should have been me!
It's gonna eat you all. What did I get?
Okay, here we go. That's right. It's my time.
How about I just knife you?
From here. Too skinny. How about the slimming corset?
Why would I want to hide my best assets from Mom Chodra? He'll be looking for a full-size meal after his long trip.
Can I borrow that bottle one more time?
Keep it!
Thanks.
I don't need it where I'm going.
That works.
Saving the best for last?
How about something bubbly to wash it down?
Well, thanks. Don't mind if I...
Trade something for a bite of that drumstick?
What do you got?
What do you got? What are you buying?
I've got a towel here if you throw me that drumstick.
You have a towel? Why didn't you say so?
I only yelled at you a bunch of times. Give me that drumstick.
Oh, how long have you been standing there?
Are you part vulture or something?
No, he's just a cannibal bird.
Here, birdie.
Oh, come on. So close.
Dang it. Still out of reach.
Where's my knife at?
How can you think about food at a time like it's not long enough?
Well, of course that it does shit.
That's it. Flap those big blue wings. Just a little bit harder. Come on, girl. Give it all you've got. Hey. How about we split this cupcake. You can have the bottom half.
It's the best part.
Get back here, you crazy brat!
That's my girl!
She's doomed us all. Mom Chocolate's fury will soon rain down upon our village.
It's like Big Bird.
Jesse brought back a girl with
him. Ooh, a new recruit. Time for your old man to become Mr. Smooth.
I swear, dude, hentai all the way in this game. Anyway, let's talk to this overprotective mom.
Hey, thanks for saving my life back there. Sorry I said you were part vulture.
Come on, Big Bird, what you got?
What do you birds do for fun around here?
Alright, I'll just fall.
Guys.
We're the preeners, of course.
We take care of the nests and keep stuff floating. Super important.
Hi, my name is Vella. What's yours?
I am Walter.
Walter?
Walter. With an apostrophe. We admire lightness in all things. No extra baggage, no extra letters.
It's like the hipster of the sky. Everyone has an apostrophe in their name and it's hard to pronounce.
Jesse.
That big blue oracle you wrote in on.
Oh, really? I guess I owe her a thank you.
Actually, take my advice. Stay away.
Why shouldn't I talk to Jesse?
Well, one of her eggs went missing when she was out.
She's totally freaking out.
Yes, I don't think the golden egg substitute we put in her nest is fooling her.
I thought you were the keepers and protectors of these birds and everything, so... it's your fault.
Poor Jesse. Where did her egg go?
It's against the preener code to point fingers.
But Gus was on cleaning duty, and it wouldn't be the first time that oaf fell through.
Shh, son. Remember what Brother Lightbeard said? Loose beaks cause leaks.
Any idea where I can find Jesse's egg?
If Gus really did take it, well, he is a little... dense, mentally and physically.
He probably fell through the clouds and went splat in the forest.
Something to laugh about.
Don't the birds tend the nests?
Well, these birds are not exactly model homemakers. Left to their own devices, they'll lay too many eggs or get too fat, and then poof, they'll sink right through the clouds.
Don't blow, stay afloat.
They can fly though, so
How are we floating on these clouds anyway?
Bully!
No, son. Try again.
Jeez. Okay. Circumference?
Area.
Yeah. It's all about
surface. It's all about math.
Pounds per square inch.
Can you guys help me? I need to get back to Sugar Bunting right away.
You're from Sugar Bunting? So that's why you smell like frost.
Why would you want to go back?
What's the big rush? Stay here and float a while.
Let's just say that Sugar Bunting is in trouble and leave it at that.
Uh-oh.
What, Pops?
Sounds like something happened at their Maiden's Feast. Not all communities are as blessed as we are here, Chet. Hopefully the upcoming ceremonies in Shellmound go more smoothly.
We just had our Maiden's Feast yesterday. It was awesome!
Brother Lightbeard was very pleased.
Good luck topping that one, Smellmound.
Okay.
Did you say that the next Maiden's Feast was in Shellmound?
Yes. It's so sad. I mean, they're always trying to compete with us, but...
Oh, yeah, total
please.
Hipsters.
Shellmound girls smell like old seaweed.
You're like 8. You wouldn't know anything about what a girl smells like.
How do I get to Shellmound?
Follow the stink?
Look, I just need to get home right away.
We have no way off this cloud, because no one wants to leave.
Mom says she does, but she doesn't really. Right, Dad?
I need to get to Mog Chothra, quick.
Good idea. If you sacrifice yourself to Mog Chothra, that might set things right.
He's very picky, though.
And you'd have to compete with the other maidens of Shellmound.
Let's go back to talking about Mareloft.
I knew this magical place would win you over eventually.
If they all stink so bad, it's not gonna be that hard to compete against all those other girls, so...
Can you tell me about Brother Lightbeard?
Happy to. Pardon me, Lightbeard is a brilliant philosopher, spiritualist, and buoyancy instructor. We have followed Brother Lightbeard up to the clouds to learn about his philosophy of lightness.
Dad gave him all our money.
Quiet, Chet.
Oh, yeah. It's a surprise for Mom's birthday.
Well, I'll see you two later.
Farewell. Stick
all right.
To the paths.
Stay on the twigs or you'll eat a pig.
No freestyling, Chet.
Sorry, Pop.
Okay, then. I think we're gonna save there and continue next time.